So what happens if we take this big HTML input and run it through our simplification procedure? Let's find this out. We click on Run. You see that the simplification algorithm correctly returns select, which actually means that it has been able to very nicely simplify this complex input into just these 8 characters. Let's take a look into how this actually operates. I'm inserting a print statement in here, which gives us a representation of the string as well as its length, so we can see whatever Simplify has been working on. And down here you can see how Simplify operates. It first takes the entire string, then it takes the first half, tests this, fails again. Of this it takes the first half, fails again, takes the first half, fails again, and there we go. With a technique like this, we can automatically simplify any input. All we need is an automated test that tells us whether the program in question passes or fails. Unfortunately, at this point, our strategy is not yet perfect. We'll have to refine it a bit, because it doesn't work well for all inputs. What happens if we put in another HTML input, that is select, foo, and end of select? What do we get as a simplified input with this function? So here's our quiz. What's the result of simplify here with this input, select, foo, and select? Is it a string consisting out of the 8 characters select? Is it a string consisting of select and the first 2 characters of foo? Is it a string consisting of select and all of foo? Or is it the entire HTML input? Over to you.